my sister was trying to light a yogurt container on fire. And I decided, oh, well, let's do a chemistry experiment. So I went into the first aid cabinet and looked for something flammable, and I found it in eyeglass cleanser. So I took the bottle of eyeglass cleanser, and then I poured it on the little candle flame that my sister had managed to start on the yogurt container. And almost instantaneously, it just erupted in a flame. And in fact, when I threw the bottle, it was so flammable that you could trace the trajectory of the liquid in the air. So then the fire alarm went off, and then, you know, this was during a time when my parents were getting ready for a Christmas party, and so my mom came out saying, "What did you do?" And when she said that, all the fire trucks showed up at the door. And a lot of people with ADHD would describe themselves as having a lot of bottled up energy that they cannot control. And, you know, you're kind of going in every direction, and you're kind of moving your leg, and you're, you know, running around, not really thinking of what your destination is. This random energy can be concentrated into one's work. So in other words, one can harness the energy and focus it into work or sports or art. When I was applying to high school, I went to private high school, there was a lot of essay writing. I remember one of the questions for one of the high school essays was, tell us something that you have dealt with throughout your life and what you've done to solve it. And I decided, well, I've had ADHD since I was 5, so let's talk about that. And after I submitted the essay, a couple months after, I'm like, you know, I kind of liked writing that story. Maybe I'll expand it. As I started writing the book seriously, and started telling people that I was writing the book, a lot of friends and also family friends started coming to me asking for advice. What I realized is what I was telling people was helping them. And I really liked the idea of publishing something that would help not just my immediate family and friends, but tens of thousands of people. And that is one of the primary reasons why I decided to pursue a career in medicine, because I feel that I can help people in medicine in a similar way that I have been able to with my advocacy work associated with my book. Medical school is a lot of work, as anybody would tell you. But I really enjoy what I'm learning. Great things about Columbia is that there is the introduction of patient interaction from day one. I have a mini clerkship once a week, and I'm also shadowing a surgeon. And I've met many patients, even though I've only been in medical school for a month. And of course, I can't give them advice yet, but it's great that I'm learning how to interact with them as a physician does. I've met a number of physicians who have told me 15 years ago, if you had ADHD in any professional field, nobody in their right mind would say it because of the stigma, especially in medicine, because people with ADHD are seen as the patients rather than the ones who should be the doctors. But I don't really think that's the case anymore. I know for a fact there are a lot of physicians who have ADHD. I would argue that the stigma is significantly reduced, even to the point that it's negligible at this point. One, learning how to perform academically, because I'm not going to lie, you have to have good grades to get into med school, and great MCAT scores and research experience and, you know, all those. On top of that, since I mentioned ADHD has a number of social problems in early childhood, kind of not knowing how to make friends, not knowing how to interact with people, Well, as a doctor, you have to know how to interact with people. You have to be able to talk to your patients, learn their problems. That is accomplished by joining groups and communities. So there's kind of two fronts that someone with, especially with ADHD, needs to learn how to do. Because as a doctor, you have to learn, you have to be able to use your textbook knowledge to interact with people. I personally like to make up mnemonics and post them, like really funny ones.
What would be okay to say on camera?
Just give me a minute here.
Let me think about this.
Some lovers try positions that they cannot handle. For each one of the bones. And it works. Even though I didn't make that one up, it's kind of, that's one of the things that we can share with each other on Facebook.